The city of Barcelona, along the Mediterranean shore of Spain, is one of the great cultural centers of Europe. There's a large boat harbor, as you can see, and there are some attractions along the waterfront, there's museums, but mostly we're going to be looking into the heart of the old city in our intensive look at Barcelona.
This is one of the great cities of Europe that you really should put on your list of places to visit. One of the loveliest things about Barcelona is the large pedestrian district. It's really incredible. It must be the largest pedestrian district in all of Europe, second perhaps to Venice, which is only pedestrians. In Barcelona, you have your cars, your streets, of course, your regular traffic. But here, there's a giant pedestrian zone that's from the medieval days.
Indeed, one of the most enjoyable activities in Barcelona is simply taking a walk through these narrow pedestrian lanes. It really is a lot of fun. You get off the main streets and into the little alleyways. They wind and bend and curve. You wonder what's around the corner just up ahead. And remember to look left and look right as you pass the alleys, and you'll come across some major buildings such as the Palau de la Música Catalana. This is a major music hall, and it was built in the late 19th century in what's called the Modernisme style. This was a version of Art Nouveau developed right here in Barcelona as a means of perfecting the Catalan identity through architecture. We have generally much older architecture in the heart of town, and some of it has been converted to new purposes, such as the Picasso Museum. It's in a series of what had been palaces and mansions, and now it's a major museum to Picasso, who lived in Barcelona for a long time. And there's also a contemporary art museum that has avant-garde cutting-edge exhibits. And then there's the great market, the food market, right in the heart of town along the Ramblas. This is open from about 7 o'clock in the morning. Even by 6:30 a.m. the merchants are setting up. So if you're an early bird, it's a fun place to come and have a look. There's not much else open at that hour of the day. And it's open throughout the day as well. Another way to see Barcelona is on an open-top bus tour. We're just showing you a little snippet here today. There's different routes these open-top buses will take. You could spend 2 hours on one route and a couple of hours on a different route, and they interconnect. And they all meet back here in the heart of town at Catalunya Square. This is really the epicenter of Barcelona. And a major street leading north from here, away from the old town, is Passeig de Gràcia. And there are some great old buildings along this major boulevard, including Casa Batlló, a masterpiece by Gaudí, the most famous architect in the history of Barcelona. He was at work 100 years ago transforming several of the important complexes in town to his unique Art Nouveau style, including Parc Güell. This was going to be a large housing development, but it went bankrupt, and instead we're left with this park pavilion and its ceramic dragon that guards the pavilion, a famous fountain, and there's some arcades around it, multicolored mosaic tile benches, and beautiful landscaping here at Parc Güell. It's a little bit out of the way, but you can get here by public bus, and it's well worth the effort. Take a stroll around, spend half an hour at least, and then carry on by public bus to Gaudí's greatest masterpiece, the cathedral called Sagrada Familia. It is like some kind of a massive mountain that's growing naturally out of the landscape, but now this is all from the mind of Gaudí, who of course never lived to see it finished. It's still being constructed. They've been working on it for nearly 100 years, and at this rate, it's going to take another 100 years to finish it. There's various kinds of political arguments, of course, about how to get the work done and how to pay for it. But it's partly open. You can ride an elevator up to the top of one of the towers, and from here you get quite a view looking out over the construction site, as well as views across the city, enjoying this incredible panorama of the skyline of Barcelona and some details of the towers of Sagrada Familia itself. The main cathedral in town is Gothic, and here we are up on the roof. Here too, you can ride up an elevator to the rooftop. We're back in the heart of the old town now in the Gothic quarter inside the major cathedral of Barcelona. This dates back to the 13th through the 15th centuries, and it has a famous cloister filled with noisy geese. Now, naturally, the cathedral is very much in the heart of the old town, so there are some lovely strolls and street musicians and a lot of people and shops all clustered within a few blocks of the cathedral. There's always some kind of music being performed in the streets, no matter what day of the week it is and no matter what month of the year. Here we are in the month of November, and people are still out in the evening. It's all very comfortable, very lively. A lot of great restaurants in this center part of town. Fabulous food at a reasonable price. There's some goat cheese on the salad. And you'll have regional specialties as well as a whole variety of international eclectic menus. Anything you want, you can find in Barcelona. It is a major city. Back into these narrow alleys at night, they take on a different kind of charm. With the siesta system, most of the shops close in mid-afternoon and then they reopen about 4 p.m. and stay open till 8 p.m., even 8:30, 9 o'clock. So it's quite rewarding and fascinating to take an evening stroll. We ran into another music group on the Ramblas from Peru, but they are performing in the traditional Spanish student style, complete with the outfits.
De Lima, Perú.
Paso a la tuna andariega, paso a la tuna andariega, la de juvenil habrá. La que arregla carretera, la que arregla carretera, lo que permite rodar. Paso a la tuna andariega, paso a la tuna andariega, la de juvenil habrá. La que arregla carretera, la que arregla carretera, por la tuna. Por fin, por fin, de construcción, cabe el mundo.
Up the next morning to continue strolling. Here we are on the Ramblas and then on into more of those little back lanes. It's fascinating to consider that Barcelona was founded about 2,000 years ago by the Romans, and many of the Roman streets are still there today. They had a clustered town surrounded by a defensive wall, and that became what is today the heart of the Gothic quarter of Barcelona. And there are some wider streets, there are some real good promenades and big department stores, along with those little boutiques and alleys, and some other squares and small parks scattered around here and there, and some very nice neighborhood restaurants. Here we ducked into this spot and had just a terrific lunch. Not expensive, real good service in this kind of a small traditional restaurant. It's just two blocks over from the Picasso Museum. And then there's the Royal Palace. It's a museum. You can pay to go inside. And down in the basement, they have got, under these streets, they've got the original Roman town. There are some original Roman streets and pavings still there. Some more of the Latin music influence. Here's the tango from Argentina, Come Back to Spain. That wraps up our look at Barcelona. Now we're heading by train into France.